Semirara Mining seeing more losses into the year. Second quarter profit dropped 41% to 6 billion pesos from the over 10 billion year-on-year. This was on lower coal and electricity prices. First half earnings were also down to 12.6 billion pesos on weaker selling prices and higher coal production costs, among others. Next to RFM Corporation, first half sales slightly up to 9.55 billion pesos. This brought its six-month net income to 650 million pesos, proving resilient despite lower input costs and operating leverage. RFM also approved today a cash dividend of 300 million pesos, payable on September 13. And finally, to Integrated Microelectronics, revenues dropped by 18% to 566 million in the first half. It attributed the lower earnings partly to its divestment of its British subsidiary, SDI Enterprises. Net loss stood at $8.8 million. The Philippine Supreme Court rules electric operatives do not have the constitutional right to an exclusive franchise within their coverage areas. This high court, in a recent ruling, denied the petition of the Iloilo Electric Cooperative. ILECO had challenged the validity of a law which expanded the franchise of More Electric and Power Corporation to areas within Ilocos' franchise area. The court also stressed allowing the entry of another player benefits consumers who no longer have to wait until the expiry of ILECO's franchises in 2029, 2039, and in 2053. A landmark prisoner swap between Russia and the U.S. brings home American journalist Evan Gershkovich and two others. President Joe Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris welcomed the released prisoners shortly after they arrived on U.S. soil. The exchange was part of a 24-person deal involving Moscow, Washington, and several other European allies. Russian authorities arrested Gershkovich in 2023 on espionage charges that the U.S. government vehemently denied. Gershkovich's long-awaited freedom was widely celebrated in his newsroom. His colleagues at the Wall Street Journal raised a toast to the development. An antitrust investigation is reportedly launched by the U.S. Justice Department into tech giant NVIDIA. This follows complaints from competitors that NVIDIA may have abused its market dominance in selling chips that power artificial intelligence. Investigators are said to be looking into whether the tech giant pressured cloud providers to buy its products and charges customers a higher price for networking gear if the customer wants to buy AI chips from its rivals. Latest estimates show NVIDIA commands about 80% of the AI chip market. In response to the issue, an NVIDIA spokesperson said the company adheres to all laws and ensures that customers can choose whatever solution is best for them.
Credit rating agency Fitch Ratings believes the Philippine banking and real estate sectors can contain the losses from the ban on offshore gaming hubs. Tama Febrian of Fitch Ratings said they do not expect commercial property developers' losses to even hit capital margins, given their strong balance sheets and diversified portfolios. Febrian expects non-performing loan ratios to slightly rise due to the loss of jobs, but adds banks can still shoulder the losses from the POGO ban since they've been limiting their exposure to POGOs. Febrian, though, admits its impact on smaller lenders is harder to gauge.
I think in terms of prices, you know, our belief is that a lot of the movements in the recent prices have not been driven by the speculative activity. Given the relatively more diminished contribution in the POGO sector and in the property sector, we don't think that the impact on the property and capital values will be significant going forward. And I think we also have to take into account that, you know, we are in an environment where we are going to be expecting a decline, you know, falling interest rates, and that will be generally positive to the real estate sector. So I think it may even stoke a demand for housing loans.